This is a co-production of the Marion Barry Summer Youth Employment Program 2020, the Jakente International. The youth employees are young playwrights, actors, and directors of the performing arts, combining in this piece of integrated art with young media and communication specialists. The start of their performance with the opening lines of the first stanza of the famous poem by Robert Hayden, Middle Passage. Then the switch to a narration of what the poem is all about, using sound effects, music, and other forms of integrated art. The closeout by showing how the events of many centuries ago around slavery, described in Middle Passage, relate to the call today for justice,
no justice,
no peace,
for racial equality, and for Black Lives Matter.
Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter!
This production is for education purposes. It is not meant for public dissemination.
Jesus, Estrella, Esperanza, Mercy. Sails flashing to the wind like weapons.
Sharks following the moans, the fever, and the dying.
Horde of corpuscent and compass rose.
Middle Passage voyage through death to life upon these shores.
10 April 1800. Blacks rebellious, crew uneasy. Our linguist says their moaning is a prayer for death. Ours and their own.
Some try to stop themselves. Lost three this morning. Leap with a crazy laughter. Two of the waiting sharks sang as they went under.
Desire adventure tartar and standing to America, bringing home black gold, black ivory, black seed.
Deep in the festering hold thy father lies. Of his bones, New England pews are made. Those are altar lights that were his eyes.
Jesus, Savior, pilot me over life's tempestuous sea. We pray that thou wilt grant, O Lord, safe passage to our vessels, bringing heathen souls unto thy testing.
We've learned a great deal about the Middle Passage.
Middle Passage narrated.
The Middle Passage was the middle leg of a voyage that starts in Europe. The first passage is from Europe to Africa. The Middle Passage is the journey from Africa to America. And then the third passage is the journey back from America to Europe.
Middle Passage. Robert Hayden wrote, it's not a poem. It's a poem extraordinaire.
It tells of a voyage through death. The Amistad set sail on the 10th of April, 1800.
From about 1525 to 1866, 12.5 million Africans were taken from their homeland and forcibly transported across the Atlantic, a journey that approximately 2 million of them would not survive.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do? Except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage.
Amidst the rough seas, wild winds, rebellious blacks, the ship's crew sickened with fear.
Maybe 10% of voyages, we know there was some attempt to rise up, to kill the crew, to try to turn the boat around, to change their destinies.
Blinded in sight, but also by hatred. Pure as gold.
Uneasy in prayer offered to Jesus Savior.
African men were shackled together and they were packed so closely together in a spool-like position. And they would stay like that for pretty much the entire journey.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Where, say, Satan's will, they were serving,
grant safe passage to our vessel, they prayed.
This tragedy could happen on any ship transporting enslaved people across the Middle Passage.
Blacks, we bring dehumanized heads and souls to that man-made hell for the living, slavery.
There are actually people dying around you, which has to be a traumatic experience for everybody on board.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Disease was rampant. Dysentery, malaria, yellow fever, smallpox, measles, and influenza ravaged the enslaved and crew members alike. Women, while usually left unshackled, were raped and sexually abused by members of the crew, sometimes arriving in the New World, carrying the children of their attackers.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Hungry sharks voyaged along, fed the dying rebellious black.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
What's crazy is those rebels died with laughter. They even sang as they went under.
The living aboard moaned a prayer for death, wishing for themselves and their captors death.
There were no sanitary facilities of any kind. Enslaved people were forced to relieve themselves where they sat, creating hellish conditions when combined with the heat and lack of ventilation below deck.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Sardine cup lying in their waist,
starving, so at thirst their own blood they drank.
Their tiny sleeping spot, same as their grave, luckier than the rebellious blacks left to burn in chains.
And who did they chastise for this? Blame those nigger kings, it wasn't me.
Those nigger kings made wars, burnt villages. They killed the old, weak, and sick.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Then they chained and led the young and strong to the Atlantic shore on voyage to the New World.
From Africa, Amistad landed on Florida coast. Blame those murderous nigger kings, you say?
Blame not our men, those brave, true Christians all. They harbored hatred so pure, best pews they built.
Flamboyant churches, altars and candles were built, molded in the bones and blood of rebellious blacks.
An offering by slave masters, those celestial Christians, those on the Amistad and others who led millions.
To enslavement in a new world's walk on Golgotha.
One of only two of America's first 14 presidents, John Quincy Adams, eloquently again spoke up.
Crime so grave, not genocide, not Holocaust, much worse.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
I say we want free movement, because we get what we deserve. We've been built, and we've been scorned.
Yet, It is those rebellious blacks who won, not lost. The end was written from the beginning. Slavery lost.
That refuses to lift its knee from the neck of my people.
How much more harm can a knee on our neck do, except remind of ours and George Floyd's Middle Passage?
Victory born of resilience, resistance, persistence.
We survived the chains, fire, rape, sharks, slavery.
What to say to close, except nothing can stop our march to freedom.